Hi everybody, and it's Advent day, day 5. Do you like my Advent calendar? That's an important question, because in today's work we're looking at do and does. Get these two words right and you'll be able to manage don't and doesn't, which we're going to do in the next video. So to begin with, do you know that we use the word do when the subject is I, you, we, or they, and it's about action when you do something? But we can use it to begin a question. So there's a picture there of a poem that some young children have written. And I might ask, do you like snow? I do like snow, could be the answer. Or you could say, I do. Because when somebody knows what you're talking about, the verb do is indicating do like. So you don't need that extra word unless you want to say it. I do like snow. Do you play in the snow? Yes, I do. So it's an action word, and you might use it to say, do I like, do you know, do we think, do they go? So think about who you use that word do with. Do you like snow? So do can replace the main verb when everybody knows what you're talking about. If you just say, yes, I do, and there's no question, that doesn't make sense. It replaces the verb when everybody knows what you're talking about. And do you know, mums love this do word because we use it all the time. Do the washing up, do your homework, do this, do that. No, we're not that mean really. But in fact, the word do can be used for imperative sentences. So check your understanding of the imperative verb. This usually comes at the beginning of your sentence, and we use do, do the washing up. Remember, when you're looking at the difference between do and does, you never, ever, ever, never use does as an imperative. You can't tell somebody to do something with the word does, but you can do it with do. You can't say does the washing up unless, not as imperative, unless you are telling somebody that person does this. So you might say, Jane does the washing up, but you can't use it to tell Jane what to do. Does the washing up, Jane? Do. So don't confuse the two. What about does then? Does, this is used with he, she, it, this, that, or if you know somebody's name, like Jane. And if it's a question, does Jane like snow? Oh, yes, she does. But you might not put the word yes. You might just say she does, and she does means she does like snow. Remember, never use does in an imperative sentence and you won't go wrong. So let's have a look at what we mean by singular subjects for does. Does. We said it was used for he, she, it, this, that, or somebody's name. So you might ask, does he like snow? Does she like snow? Does it matter if it snows? Does this amount of snow count? Does that amount of snow count? Does Jane think it is going to snow? Well, I'll let you into a secret. I just read that it's going to snow for 15 days. I'm not sure it's true. Do you think this is true? So don't confuse do and does. Get this right and the rest of the work we're doing will follow. So use do for I, you, we, or they. Use does for he, she, it, this, that, or name. Anybody's name. There's that poem again. It's written by young children. It's really lovely. It's about the snow. So I might ask the question, do the children fall in the snow? So I'm talking about they. Do they fall in the snow? And that's why I use do. Do the children, it means do they. Does the child fall in the snow? Singular now. So the child, does she? Does he? Does Bobby fall in the snow? So there we have name. Does the snow fall slowly? And does the sun make the snow sparkle and glitter? So how did that work? Well, remembering again, do or does. Do you, like my advent calendar, do you think I should read the book for Advent Day 5? Does the size of the advent calendar this thing? Do you want to buy one? Does the cost of the advent calendar? So we're talking about a thing when we're talking about the cost or the size. So we're going to use does. Do you think this advent calendar is more expensive than the other one? And remember, if you're talking about it, you say it does, reversing does it. Does it make a difference? It does. I do, when we're talking about want to buy one. Do you want to buy one? I do. I do want to buy one. Are we talking about the cost? So when we say does the cost, we say the cost does make a difference. And do you think this calendar? Turn it round. I do think. So remember, in the question, you're just reversing. Do you? I do. Does the use? The use does. Do I? I do. So think about question, the top, statement or answer that's at the bottom. And don't forget, this bit is really important because the recap of the rules you need to follow. When you use do in a sentence, it can be the first word when the sentence is a question. When you use does in a sentence, it can be the first word if the sentence is a question. That's important. When it's a question. So do and does can both go anywhere else in the sentence if it's not a question. Remember, do is used for plural subjects, more than one. And if you're using the words I, you, we, and they, does is used for singular subjects, one subject. And when you're using the words he, she, this, it, that, and name. So once you've got those rules in your head and you're very clear, we can move on to look at why we're confusing does not and don't. So the first very important thing is don't confuse do and does. Learn the rules and make sure you know why you're using those words. And I'll be back tomorrow with day 5 and a little test about do and does, because we'll be talking about does not, doesn't, and don't. So practice this, because this is our online lesson this week and we're going to focus on do, does, don't, doesn't. Bye now.